Hello, my name's Michelle and I'm in the adult chorus of the Louth Playgirls production of Oliver. So during this lockdown, I've been up to all sorts of different things, from baking and cooking to dancing and singing. So for those who know me, know that I absolutely love to dance. There is nothing that I would rather do in this whole entire world. But I've come across a few little issues with dancing in lockdown. Number one, I'm not allowed to dance in my house because I either break something or I break myself. Number two, if I go out into the garden to dance, my dogs seem to think that I'm playing with them and just get in the way. However, I did find a little board, so I have been having a little go at tap on the board. In a world where we are having to adapt to everything, I have had to adapt to this because the board literally fits 1.5 my tap shoes this way, maybe 2.5 my tap shoes this way. So yeah, here's a little clip of my tap dancing. I've also been playing my musical instruments. I've been playing my guitar, my ukulele and my flute. And for the first time in 8 years, I picked up my cello a few weeks ago. And I'm not sure how it got to that stage, because those who knew me growing up would know that the cello was my main instrument. I mean, I'm definitely not the standard I was 8 years ago. But I'm going to play a little clip. Maybe you can guess the song. Maybe you might have heard the musical it's from. I won't be offended if you can't. So, for those that know me know that I love to sing. But I like to sing in a group. Not really one for singing by myself. But obviously with lockdown, it's left me with no choice. So I have been singing a few songs. So I'm gonna play a little clip of me singing In a Crowd of Thousands from Anastasia.
A parade passing by, it was hot, not a cloud in the sky. Then a boy caught my eye. In a crowd of thousands, he was thin, not too clean. There were guards, but he dodged in between. Yes, he made himself seen in that crowd of thousands, and he called out my name as he started to run through the sun and the heat and the crowd. And I tried not to smile, but I smiled. And then he bowed.
I feel as I should address the hairdressing situation. So first off, well done girls. There is no way that I could cut a fringe into my own hair. I've wanted to fringe for about 2 years and I don't even let a hairdresser cut it in. So not happening in this house lockdown. However, I have been nominated, and I'm not sure why, as the Scott family hairdresser. So we've got some clippers and that to do the boys' hair. And both my dad and my brother sat down on the chair and they spoke to me as if I was an actual hairdresser and knew what I was doing. I don't. The only little bit that helped me along the way was that the guards on the clippers have numbers. I mean, I didn't make them bald. Well, I nearly did, because I nearly forgot to put the guard on once, but it's fine. Their hairs look like fine. It's okay. And yeah, I think my final thing to say in this vlog, definitely not a YouTuber, is that I've been learning something, or relearning something very close to my heart, something I did a lot when I was younger and just had no need to really do it. So I've been relearning British Sign Language. So with that in mind, I'm going to love you all and leave you all with this little message.
Thank you, NHS and key workers, please. Stay home, stay safe, and I'll see you in September.